Training Group presents our next video in a series. This particular one is on how to install a Crimson Trace laser grip, model LG431, onto a Ruger LCP. Now, this is a fairly simple process. The instructions are pretty clear. It's not rocket science, but just in case anybody wants to be walked through the process, we're going to do that here. Now, first we're going to start by locking the slide to the rear on the Ruger, which is done by pushing backwards on the slide and pushing up on the slide lock. We're going to remove the magazine, make sure it's out of the way, physically and visually inspect this weapon in the chamber and the magwell to make sure that it's clear, and let the slide go back forward. You can probably do this with a slide back, it's no big deal. There's no ammunition in my work area, so I'm not overly concerned about somebody walking in and loading my gun without my knowledge. I'm going to open the box. This is a brand new grip. This is actually being installed on a customer or client's gun. In the foam package comes a two-part clamshell type laser. That's all there is to this. As you can see, these two pieces fit together like pieces of a puzzle. Now, particularly interesting is the way that this small piece here at the bottom, the back of it, near the activation button, fits together. Now, that's important when you go to put this thing together, because this has to slide in and fit just right. And then this goes together, and there are two small screws that secure this into place. Should be able to see on the video how this slides together and closes. Now, in the box, you're going to find a Ziploc bag, and it's going to have several parts. Don't want to lose these, because most all of them are important. Battery, cleaners, little swabs to clean the laser, some stickers, which you're not going to probably use unless you want to put stickers on your gun, a couple Allen wrenches, and a couple very small Allen screws. There again, do not lose these. You'll be doing the armorer's crawl, as the armorer say, crawling around the floor looking for them. So typically get you a cloth or a towel or something put down on the table so things don't roll around. Okay, once I've removed the battery from the package, you'll notice that there's a plus positive on one end of this thing and a negative on the other. You'll also notice that the flat end, you've got the one with the insulation around it with the negative, the flat end is positive. Positive, you want to go up towards the laser. You slide this in here, it fits flush, push the button to make sure the laser comes on. If it doesn't come on, you probably have it backwards. If you put it in backwards, that's really all that's going to happen, is it's just not going to work. Pick the pistol up. You'll need to, down here at the bottom, there's a little lip here that snaps over the bottom of the trigger guard right in front of the magazine catch here. Press this up onto the weapon, and then simply take this bottom part down here, push it in this way until it sort of catches. Wiggle it around till you find that spot, making sure that both sides are overlapping the trigger guard, and then squeeze this together. It'll join up all the way around the edges and fit and look like this. Now, next thing you're going to do is you're going to insert these long screws into the side of the weapon. Take your Allen wrench and tighten this down. You see the Allen wrench just goes in. Don't think there's any particular order that these have to be tightened in. You just want to get them snug. Now, Now, keeping in mind, there's a lot of plastic here, so we don't want to cinch these down so tight that we strip anything out. But you want to make sure that this gap on the bottom has gone away and that it's a fairly tight fit. I just turn it until I feel it get some tension, but not so you're not going to get it squeaky tight, because all you're going to do then is break it. Now, squeeze the button here with the activation button with the middle finger. Hold the gun, index your finger alongside a weapon. With the magazine out, you really only get this finger and this finger on it. Everything else is missing this thing. But that is a typical shooting grip for this weapon. Make sure the laser comes on. Now, Crimson Trace says, and their packaging materials, that there must be these two little stickers need to be placed on the weapon. The aperture sticker here near the front of the weapon, and the danger laser sticker back here somewhere. Now, that's a factory recommendation, and that's entirely up to you whether you want to install that or not. It also says that the Crimson Trace laser grip is sighted in at 50 feet from the factory, at 50 feet. Now, that's quite a ways out there. I found that to be true with this particular laser, that it was very much on. However, the windage can be adjusted without any problem at all. What I do is find something very firm to set it on, pick me a spot a reasonable distance away. And if it is off left to right, the windage, this little hole right here on the side, you just turn it to move it back and forth. It's very obvious which way it goes. Make sure you can see where this goes in at. Right here at the front, right behind the laser aperture. If it's up and down is off the elevation, then you just simply insert it here and turn this left or right, clockwise or counterclockwise, to bring this laser dot up and down. A very simple process. Now, you can find these lasers. Most of you have a hard time finding the Ruger pistols, but once you get it, if you're in the market for a Crimson Trace laser grip for any pistol, you name it, anything Crimson Trace makes, we carry at talontraininggroup.com. Go to our website at shop.talontraininggroup.com. You should see it right down here at the bottom of the screen. Our website's there, and go to our website, check us out. We try to keep the lowest prices we can, and try to explain our products as best we can. If you'll check our website out also, we've got some demo videos on wallet holsters, some of the Black Hawk holsters, and here before too long, we're going to be producing our own line of nylon holsters. We currently offer our own line of leather holsters, which are a great item to help you carry these things. Because the beauty of this pistol, and this is not an enjoyable pistol to shoot, you don't get it because it's a great and comforting thing to use. You get this because you can stick this in your pocket and you can carry 6+1 rounds of 380 in your pocket, draw it out, and engage a target quickly and accurately. The laser dot, the benefit of it is simply that you put a red dot on somebody and point a gun at them. I'm not just saying, fella, I'm going to shoot you. I'm saying, fella, I'm going to shoot you right there where that red dot is. So it's a very convincing thing to have. Law enforcement officers have found that lasers on tasers, electronic control devices, have been very effective in deterring people from using force. And lasers on firearms are becoming more and more popular, especially with Crimson Trace fine line of products. Hey, I trust these things. I carry one on mine. And, I don't know how I can say much more than that. Anyway, check us out at our website, purchase your products. We'll get them shipped out to you as quick as we can.